Hello, I'm Chance.
And Sam.
And we're here to try new tropical Swedish fish. Minis fish.
I keep running into a board down there. Sorry, guys.
Swedish Fish Mini Tropical. Sam looks super pleased.
I'm tired. Anybody who works retail will understand. Being on your feet 8 hours or more a day. Not the same people think it is.
Looks like they have four flavors. Let's try the white one first. Pina colada. Try to get our...
Not the palate cleanser, but hey, not gonna argue. I'm just not usually a Swedish fish person.
I think the closest I've come is I had the Swedish fish Oreos.
I don't hate this.
It kind of tastes like a pina colada.
But it's got that very, very strong, artificial going on.
Yeah, and you can tell it's a gummy. It
doesn't have the regular Swedish fish taste, which I'm not mad about. I'm not a big licorice person. No.
Here's the purple one. It's called Passion Fruit. Ow. Fuck my elbow.
Did it pop?
No, it refuses to.
I'm just getting like a very like artificially smell.
I'm mad at it.
No, but this one has the same thing going on as that.
Yeah, but you can't taste what it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
I'd definitely eat these over regular Swedish fish. And then again, I can't judge too much because...
Beachy Punch?
Let's go with the orange one next.
Tropical Island. And the myth factor continues.
Actually, I like this one. Maybe I am like the target demographic for this gummy.
I think it's like,
A little more even.
Papaya, maybe?
Yeah, papaya, I think.
Because I wouldn't say it's very mango-y. And if it's supposed to be mango, it's off.
Yeah, you done fucked up.
Yeah, that's not a mango flavor anybody wanted or asked for.
But papaya.
I would bank on that being like a papaya-based flavor.
What's this last one?
Beachy Punch.
I'm wondering...
Fruit Punch, yeah.
I'm kind of wondering the fidelity of Swedes figuring out tropical flavors.
Now he questions it.
Sweden is very cold.
The camera's gonna pick that up, so the whole video is gonna do one of these.
Our dog is acting as cameraman today.
Well, also his knee. So, for the camera shaking, people, I apologize, it's not me.
It's me.
I don't know what that's supposed to be.
I don't know, but I like it. Kinda. Feels tropical. I couldn't fucking nail down what it is, but.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, if somebody heard tropical, and they're like, oh, I think it tastes like this, that's what that one tasted like.
These all taste like good tropical flavors.
But from somebody who's never actually had tropical fruit.
Yeah, as described by somebody who's only vaguely seen them.
Oh, it looks like this, it must taste like this, I think. question mark? But, yeah,
Cameo!
It's mocha. Okay, so I don't hate them. But they're probably never going to be something that I decide that I want to pay for.
I'd buy them again.
He would. I would not. I'm going to stick with my kettle corn sprinkle on for the popcorn. Like, that's where my happy place is going to be. I really like that. I got it. Didn't actually film it, but it's delicious, guys.
We should have filmed it.
It was really good. But it was also, like, at game. So, if you notice, there's a bowl of popcorn on the game table. That's what that is. It's coated in a kettle corn flavor.
Title drop, Game Table Adventures. You should watch it.
But if I had to rate it, where would that sit?
I'd give it a 6 on my candy spectrum. Above average candy eating.
4.5.
Fake tropical flavors. That's,
better than the...
That's the ticket.
Blueberry muffin Kit Kats.
I'd rate it up there with it.
Again, I didn't find them all that pleasing.
If there are major candy corporations watching our videos with just this deep-seated desire to know what makes us tick, for me, any kind of fake tropical fruit flavors, if you do them right, primo.
If I'm going to do tropical fruit, I kind of prefer the real thing, but I'm not going to be mad at something that's, you know, flavored like a piña colada. Well... And that's, I think, kind of the key, is if you're going to do flavors for things, you have to do them well, otherwise you just get a whole lot of artificial.
You get a lot of meh.
Yeah.
Nobody wants meh.
So, for me, like, that whole box is probably going to sit at meh.
I like it.
I wouldn't buy it again.
I'm
going to
eat the rest of these. Hey, I have eaten the rest of most of the things we reviewed on this show.
Except for the pork rinds, which I'm really kind of sad about.
We ate most of those.
No, we really didn't. We ate, like, a couple out of the bag for the episode. And don't get me wrong, guys, they were good, but
I kept eating them, but not...
They just sat on the table for a while, and then they disappeared.
I didn't throw them away, because I was still munching on them, but then one day I munched on one, and It was time to throw them away.
It was due. By the way, anybody who has seen the pork rind episode, link somewhere probably down below, they do carry them at Walmart. I actually saw them putting stuff away
I don't think those have been posted yet.
Well, I mean, eh. Then my editor should hurry. I'm sure he's going to have a roll with that one.
Yeah, we have been, sorry.
Josh, I love you.
Sorry for the little hiatus that may or may not have been experienced at this point. We were out of edited videos to upload, and we missed our upload window yesterday, so...
We are working on getting stuff done. It's just been a lot of kind of things happening all at once. We had a couple of friends come down with COVID, and then... We haven't really had a lot of time to game. We've had things that have been more important in life kind of going on right now. So things may continue to be a little bit chaotic for a minute, but we are hoping to get on a steady schedule. So
yeah, we'll be back.
Keep an eye out, guys.
We'll be back to regularly updating. And with that said, keep adventuring.